Abu Hamza Thumali, the companion of Imam al-Sajjad alayhi salam, comes to see him, to visit him. And he finds him weeping, crying, in pain. 35 years almost, Imam al-Sajjad lived after Karbala. Every day he cries, he mourns, he weeps. Abu Hamza tells him one day, Yabna Rasulullah. He's trying to comfort Imam al-Sajjad. Says, Yabna Rasulullah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has honored you, Ahlul Bayt, with martyrdom, shahada. Look at your grandfather, Amir al-Mu'mineen. Look at al-Imam al-Hasan. And the same of you to your father as well. He also got martyred. So why do you continue to weep and cry in such a state of grief, pain? Imam al-Sajjad told him, Shakar Allah sa'yaka ya Aba Hamza. May Allah have mercy on you, ya Aba Hamza. Thank you. Allah bless you. I know you're trying to comfort me. While it is true, ya Aba Hamza, that Allah has honored us with martyrdom. But since when have our women been taken as prisoners? Every time I look at my aunts, I look at my sisters, I look at the women, the children, I remember them running on the day of Ashura from one tent to another tent. As the enemies are burning the tents. My aunt Zainab came to me and she said, my nephew, what shall we do? I told her, take the children, the women run away from the fire. Protect them from the fire. Imam al-Hussain alayhi salam on the eve of Ashura told Zainab, Ya Zainab, tomorrow I'm leaving this dunya. I'm being killed. But I want you to take care of the women and the children. You are responsible during this journey. My son Ali is ill. He is incapable of helping. She said, I will take care of them, Ya Aba Abdullah. I will look after them. And indeed, that pain that they endured, that difficulty that they endured, going from from Karbala to Kufa, and from Kufa to Sham in the court of Yazid ibn Muawiyah, where the children of Al-Imam al-Hussein saw him picking up a rod and hitting the face of the Imam salamullahi alayhi on his mouth. And no one is saying a word. So Zainab alayha salam, one of the little girls of Imam al-Hussein, says, Amma, my aunt, tell Yazid not to beat the head of my father. She gets up and she says, Ya Yazid, do you know how many times Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi has kissed that mouth? Take your hands off the head of Abi Abdullah. And she delivered that amazing sermon, that khutbah, in which she told him, you do whatever is in your power. I swear by Allah, you will never stop people from remembering us. Indeed, here we are almost 1400 years later, crying for Abi Abdullah al-Hussein, remembering Abi Abdullah al-Hussein. As we speak right now, millions of Zawar are heading to Imam al-Hussein and crying, Labbayka ya Hussein. But then at night in Sham, one of the little girls of Al-Imam al-Hussein alayhi salam, who was about 3 years of age, her name was Ruqayyah. She was too young to realize that her father had been killed. She would ask Zainab alayhi salam, Amma, where is my father? How come I don't see him? I miss him. And she would be told that he's in a journey, in a long journey, referring to the journey of the Akhirah. Until one night she got up in the middle of the night in Sham. She cried, Amma Zainab, Aina Walidi Al-Husayn? Where is my father, Abi Abdullah? I just saw him in my dream. I saw myself hugging him. Where is he? I miss him. Zainab alayha salam tried to comfort the little girl. My little girl, he's in a long journey. She says, Amma Zainab, but I just saw him in my dream. I want him. I want to see him. So when the women heard, they started crying. They started mourning. The news reached the palace of Yazid. He said, what is the matter? They told him, one little girl of Al-Husayn has gotten up in the middle of the night and she's asking about her father, Abi Abdullah. He says, then take the head of her father to her. They put the head in a golden plate and they covered the plate. They brought it to this young lady. When she first saw the plate, she thought there is food in the plate. So she turns to her aunt Zainab, قالت عم زينب لقد عزفت نفسي عن الطعام. My aunt Zainab, I do not want food. I want my father, Abi Abdullah al-Husayn. When the little girl then lifts the cover of the plate, she sees the head of her father in the plate covered in blood. She threw herself on the head of her father crying, Aywa Abata, Aywa Husayna. All those fathers who have little daughters who are 3 years old, 4 years old, 5 years old, I want you to remember Ruqayyah. Oh, remember your little girls when they were of that age. How did they used to come and hug you, look after you, miss you, call you? And now think of this little girl on the head of her father crying, Aywa Husayna, Aba man lil aytayam wal nisa'i ba'dak. Oh father, who will take care of the women and the orphans after you? She continued to cry, Aywa Abata, Aywa Abata, Aywa Abata. Until she went into deep silence. That's when Imam Al-Sajjad alayhi salam turned to his aunt Zainab and said, Amma Zainab, irfa'iha min ala ra'si walidi, falakad faraqat al-hayat. Lift her from the head of my father. My sister has joined my father in Jannah. Zainab alayha salam came to the little girl. She turned her around. She saw that she is lifeless. She carried her and she turned towards the head of Imam al-Husayn and said, Ya Abu Abdullah, Akhi Hussein, unzur ilayna. Oh brother Hussein, look at us. Look at the difficulties I'm enduring in this journey. Look what has happened to us. And this little girl was buried in Sham. The caravan then came back to go to Karbala. When they arrived in Karbala, Zainab alayhi salam threw herself on the qabr of Imam al-Husayn and cried, Assalamu alayka ya Aba Abdullah. Brother Hussain, I've come back, but I wish you can see my body and the wounds and the scars from the enemies of Allah beating me. And then she said, Ya Abu Abdullah, this is how the poets now describe. They describe an apology between Zainab and Imam Al-Hussein. As if Zainab is saying, Akhi Aba Abdullah, I have an apology to make. Why would you want to apologize, Ya Zainab? You asked me to take care of the women and the children. I tried my best, Ya Aba Abdullah, but your daughter Ruqayyah remained in Sham. When the caravan then came back to Medina, Imam Al-Hussein alayhi salam left a little girl of his by the name of Fatima al-Sughra or Fatima al-Alil. She was too ill, so he was afraid that she might not make it through the journey. He kept her in Medina. When they came back and she heard of the tragedies, what happened to the man, she started crying and weeping. But then she noticed, she said, Amma Zainab, you said the men were killed, but where is my sister Ruqayyah? I don't see Ruqayyah. Why isn't she back? She cried and said, Ya Fatima, عظم الله لك الأجر. Ruqayyah died on the head of your father, Abi Abdullah, in Sham. I buried her in Sham. Fatima cried. She said, Ya Amma, I would spend so much time with Ruqayyah. I miss Ruqayyah. وإنا إليه راجعون وسيعلم الذين ظلموا أي منقلب ينقلبون والعاقبة للمتقين